Everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today is part three of creating a water feature. If you're coming back from watching part two, welcome back. If this is the first time you've seen our video, please subscribe right here and become part of our garden family. We have hopes of getting a lot done today, so come on along and join us. Another day on the job. It's a beautiful day. I think it almost hit 80, but it's kind of windy, but that's okay because it keeps you cooler. Richard's been working hour by hour, and he now has all the sides finished and decorated. Now over here, you can see the beginning of the water
spillover
itself. So the water will be piped up. Will drop into that little bed right there and continue on down on its pathway.
Well, once I get that all framed in, then I will be starting on the front spillover.
Yep.
That's going to be another day again.
Oh, at least. Yes.
So, pretty soon, I'd say maybe about Monday, might be able to get the
pond
liner.
I'm telling you right now.
Okay, well then Tuesday.
Okay. Another beautiful day in the neighborhood. Yes, here we are outside working again. It's in the 80s again. And then tomorrow it's going to rain. Whew. Thank goodness.
A day of rest.
Yes. Inside work has to be done. Okay, so what we wanted to show is how we're coming along. This is how it's going to look when it's all finished. And we decided that we would start staining so that we could start planting. We have lots of plants that we're moving around and new plants coming. So the sooner we can get that done and the soil fixed and amended, the better. Now this is how it's looking in the back. Water will be coming from over there where that post is. It'll go down here into a little shallow pond, and then it'll trickle over into the big pond, and from there it goes over here and it goes down there again, trickles down into the big pond. Should be wonderful. Hello. Deja vu all over again. It seems like we were just in this pit and now we're back again. We spent yesterday creating the front spillover, the important part where the focal point of this whole water display will be here. So Rick created this. He created this side so that it would control where the spillover comes out and it's not splashing all over. This is where the water will fall down and it'll go onto these rocks. So we had to make sure that this whole area was encased in rubber so that all of our hard work wouldn't rot away because it was underwater. Now, this is what's coming. Before we can put the rubber in the bottom and up on the sides, Rick has to go and sand everywhere that there is the possibility of a screw or a piece of wood that could poke through the rubber liner. That would just defeat our whole purpose. So today will probably be spent doing that, and once that's done, then we can try to move this big heavy piece of rubber in place and attach it.
This is really awkward.
It's very awkward. It's very heavy.
And it's larger than the ones we wanted, too.
Yes, yes. We got a deal on the rubber because these pieces were already cut, but they were a little larger than we wanted, but they didn't charge us a cutting charge, which was nice, and which, you know, we may be able to use what's left over for other purposes. Yesterday, we had, the night before yesterday, we had 1.25 inches of rain, which we really, really needed. But we saw how well the sand compacted down and leveled itself out. That was very nice.
Yep. That was a big surprise because we had standing water in the pit that I had to drain out.
Yes.
And now with the sun out today, we can finally let it dry out a little bit more.
Except that tonight and tomorrow morning, it's going to rain again.
Well, that's why I wanted to get this in, because this will be the main part. So
Yes. This
will be fun. Once this is done, then I can start capping everything and start finishing and start doing all the little Mickey Mouse work, and finally we can stain it. And
it would be nice.
Fill it up and enjoy it.
Oh, get busy now. Hurry up.
I'm hungry.
Is it time to go swimming yet? No, I guess not. But you can see how things are taking place and how they're working out. First, we started at the front there because we needed to have enough material in here for the spillover. So in order to get that in place, we needed to tack that corner and then make sure there's enough, and then we worked our way back to this corner. Now what we're trying to do is to get as sharp a corner in here as possible. And it actually is looking pretty good, because once we wiggle it around a little bit, it'll do fine. So then we go around here, then we'll tack over here, and we'll be able to cut off what we don't need, and then configure up here how it's going to look on the side. Now this extra is what we were really hoping we'd have, because we want to line the bottom of line the sides of the bottom water feature so that it looks all nice and bright and new, and it'll be really pretty.
Well, that's, you know, this is kind of like wrapping a gift. You know,
from
you
the
have
inside.
You have to know how to wrap the corners.
Right, but
that's
you're
the
wrapping
trick.
The inside of the box and not the outside
that's
of the box.
That's right.
Get the easy part. You've heard us mention that we're going to be putting a cap over the top of where the rubber is, comes up to the top of the side. So this is the cap that we're talking about, and it just goes right on here like this as soon as I can maneuver. There we go. And it makes it look so much more finished. And I can sit on this part, and it'll be comfortable and easy to look in.
Go fishing. Put your feet in summer to stay cool, right?
Of course. Now that we have the caps in place, they of course need to be screwed in. And that's what these 3.5-inch nails or screws are for.
And these are deck screws.
Yes, they are. Not affected by water. It was done. But it could be here all day with me doing this.
Gee, you mean you're not doing all this work?
No, I am your gopher.
Oh.
I am your holder. I am your heavy weight when you need somebody to hold something in place.
So in other words, you're pretending to put this together?
No, I'm assisting.
Oh,
and
okay.
Supervising.
Oh, okay.
And bringing you food and spreckers.
There you go. That sounds like a plan.
Now you see these 2x4s under here, and they are upright like this. They not only add stability on the top to keep this board from warping, but they also fasten into the boards beneath to keep them from warping as well.
And it also helps with the end grain too, to know that the end grain is actually curving downward.
Right. And this is all from the brain of my husband, who is so creative and so amazing. I just sit here watching him thinking, how in the world is he doing this? Creative.
It's easy.
Yeah, no, it isn't.
You could do it.
No, I couldn't.
Sure you could.
No.
You're doing it right now.
I'm your cleanup crew. When it comes to the back top edge, the topping edge like we have here, the caps, Rick decided that he would make a bigger area that we could put either a garden ornament or a potted plant or something up there. So what's going to happen is we're going to just fold this back. It will be anchored in this 2x4, so it's not going anywhere. And then the water will come and spill down on here and into here.
Well, the tubing, the water tubing is actually going to come along this edge and be secured and then come up over or possibly even through this with maybe 4 or 5 jets coming in just as a spillover.
Right. So this is probably little pebbles of some kind, perhaps?
Possibly.
Okay.
Haven't decided.
Sounds good. Well, we have had a very productive day. Maybe our most productive as far as constructing goes. We got rubber in the bottom of the lower pond. We got the rubber inside the big pond.
Starting to work on the trim work.
Now we're working on, and that's about all that's left is the trim work and the little details that you're doing. Got some of the stain started. So when it rains tonight, I won't be standing in water to do it. But I'd say we did really well today.
I have to agree. I think this was by far our most productive day so far.
At least it shows things that we did.
Yeah. Well, the fact that it's going to rain tonight and tomorrow, I mean, this is going to be a good test for several areas.
Whether we're waterproof or not.
Yeah. The one big area that we still have to deal is that overflow. That's probably going to be the first area that we're going to actually cement rubber to rubber and really get that sealed. It's pitch, so when the water level gets to that level, that lower level,
it'll flow down.
Then it'll flow over. And again, the same back here. I had to do a little trimming to even everything off, but I think it's starting to take shape.
Yep, looks good. And now it's cold, so now we have to go in the house.
Well, plus I'm hungry again.
Again?
Yeah, so I promise I'm going to treat you tonight.
Well, we got a lot done today, and we're happy with it. So if you'd like to stay tuned for part 4, hopefully the final episode, I hope it is too, please tune in again. If you enjoyed our presentation and maybe learned something or sweated along with us, give us a thumbs up. We'd appreciate that. See you next time. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube and subscribe to our channel.